Around me is a wide space of pure nothingness, bright and infinite. No ground, no walls, no sky. I feel so light. I tried to wave my hand in front of my eyes, but nothing showed up. I looked down, or so what I thought to be down, and there's also nothing. I can't see my own body. Am I dead? I thought. I don't have any recollection of how long I have been in this place, or what happened before that. The only thing that I for sure know is, humanity had gone. Suddenly, a dark smoke emerged in front of me, slowly clumping together and manifesting into a familiar humanoid figure. Who are you? I asked. No response. Deep inside, I have a strong feeling that the figure is someone bonded tightly with my consciousness, but I don't have any memories to confirm it. I don't remember the face. I don't remember the name. There's nothing to worry about now. A voice echoed from the endless white space that sounded, again, very familiar. You've done your part. The figure in front of me disintegrates into thin air. What do you mean? I replied. I could hear a collective of painful and distressing screams getting louder around me, harmonizing each other in an agonizing choir. I'm really sorry, the familiar voice said in a sarcastic, mournful tone. But you were enjoying it, didn't you? Enjoy? What did I enjoy? Before I uttered any question, the familiar voice continued. It started as hunger, but as the mind breaks down more and more, the body will eventually lessen its cardinal state and succumb to what it was once. I froze, trying to understand the words. I wanted to say something, but forming thoughts into sentences was getting really difficult. Your fate was sealed from the beginning. You can't escape it. The familiar voice chuckled. How does it feel when the puppet finally becomes the puppeteer? A huge portion of the white space spread open, creating a dark rift contrast with everything else around it. Through the rift I can see a spiral cluster of dust and rocks that I recognize as a galaxy. With an unknown force, my vision zoomed into the galaxy faster than the speed of light. The black void now engulfed me, leaving the white space behind. I don't know how long time has passed. It almost feels like the concept of time crumbles as my thought ability deteriorates bit by bit. As I started to slow down, I faced something that looked like the solar system. I'm passing the planets one by one, gazing at the giant body I never saw in close proximity before for a few seconds, then moving to the next one. I finally stopped. My thought process had completely gone. In front of me was the planet Earth, home for all known life. A place where people with ambitions, dreams, and imagination cherish their life together, even with the species with lesser intelligence. But that's what it used to be. The Earth that I see is not a lush, green and blue planet I used to know. All land masses covered in fleshy mass with nightmarish amalgamation form that I couldn't describe, while the ocean is now tinted red. It speaks to me, chanting words in that familiar voice. I can't cover my ears.